Then when you come to fundraising events, yeah, I think most NGOs, charities, they always have fundraising events or campaigns, awareness campaign and so on, in order not only to raise money but also to spread their message. Now, here there is tax relief from GST, but only up to 4 events a year. Only up to 4 events a year. From the 5th event onwards, standard rate of GST applies. Now, at the same time, it's not so simple also. To do a fundraising event that is tax exempt, you need to get prior approval from the Director General of Customs. You have to submit the entire list of all the supplies that you intend to sell and do in the event. And then you get approval. And also, the event cannot be organized by a professional fundraiser. It must be organized by, you know, by yourself. Or if you engage somebody who is professionally organizes fundraising events, there's also GST will apply. It will not be tax exempt. So as you can see, it's very complicated and it just makes it much more difficult for NGOs to raise funds. And even proceeds from their other activities, you know, a lot of NGOs, in order to meet or supplement their income, they will sometimes rent their halls, you know, for weddings or dinners and so on, or they sell their merchandise, or give treatments, you know, dialysis and so on, or give training workshops, do translation work, maybe give advertising space in their magazines and things. All this will be taxed GST, as long as even ambulance service, which is paid, even paid ambulance service will be charged GST. It doesn't matter if all the proceeds will go back to the charity and be used for charitable reasons, it will still be taxed. Okay. And actually in Malaysia, unlike other countries, developed countries, charities receive very little aid from the government. Yeah, they actually receive very little. I think even St. Nicholas here can tell you that they're actually a very big outfit in Penang. St. Nicholas is running on a very big budget, but they get a very, very, very small grant from the government, from the federal government. So the support from federal government is actually very small. And instead of giving more support, they're actually taking away money from charities. So instead of giving, government will be taking from charity. Yeah, with the GST, this is essentially what will happen, because the government will take a share of the donations and the proceeds and so on, which is meant actually for charity. This is actually an ironic reversal, which will reduce the real value of contributions.
The other major negative impact of GST on charity will be increase in the cost of complying with the complex bookkeeping procedure of GST. Not only now, charities and non-profit will suffer from cash flow problem because of the reduction in donation now that charity is much more expensive, as was described by Daryl. They will have to be hiring accountants, professionals to maintain and process records in order to claim GST input tax, or even to declare their GST output tax. So there will be increase in operational costs. So there are a few recommendations that we want to propose to the government. Firstly, of course, as we have always said, the nation is not prepared for GST as of now. Yeah? So, and in light of this negative impact on GST on charities and non-profit organizations, the government should consider immediately to defer the implementation of GST until further consultation and until a time when we have become a more mature and a high-income nation. In other countries, charities are supported by government. For example, in the US, in Europe, as well as in Singapore, where government actually provides matching grant to charities to support them, but not here in Malaysia. Most charities in Malaysia are dependent on private and corporate sector donations. So we hope that the government will defer GST until sometime until further in the future.